गुड मॉर्निंग, आई एम सुभस्मिता बरड, वेलकम यू टू सेकेंड लेक्चर वीडियो ऑफ ऑप्टिकल मिनरोलॉजी। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द पेट्रोलॉजिकल माइक्रोस्कोप एंड इट्स पार्ट्स एंड देयर फंक्शन। सो लेट अस नो अबाउट द व्हाट इज मिनरल एंड इन व्हिच वे वी कैन स्टडी the properties of minerals. Minerals are characterized by certain definite physical properties, chemical composition, optical property and internal molecular structure, and hence the study of mineral is made under different heads, that is physical mineralogy, chemical mineralogy, optical mineralogy and x-ray mineralogy. Now the optical properties such as twinkling, birefringence, refractive index are important for identification of minerals individually and also when they are the constituents of the rocks. Optical mineralogy deals with the study of different optical property of different mineral in thin section of grain under petrological microscope, which differ from ordinary biological microscope having a set of extra settings. This is your simple biological microscope and this is petrological microscope. Biological microscope measure only ordinary light. That ordinary light is not suitable for determination of optical property of mineral. The light that is suitable for study of the optical property is polarized light. So it is also called polarized microscope. So in the polarizing microscope, or it is a type of microscope used in the thin section of minerals and rocks are studied. So it is different from ordinary microscope. It has two prism called Nicol prism. It is used for determination the optical properties of transparent crystalline mineral. To study minerals under microscope, the thin section are prepared about 0.035 millimeter. These thin section are placed on the rotating stage of the microscope and then examined. Now comes to the parts of petrological microscope. So the parts are the microscopic tube, the ocular and eyepiece, then Bertrand lens, this is your Bertrand lens, analyzer, then the accessory plates or accessory opening, then objective lens, arm and base, this is your arm and this is your base, then microscopic stays, or it is also known as rotating stays, substage apparatus, this is your stage and this all are substage apparatus, the condenser, then iris diaphragm, then the polarizer, or it is also known as Lower Nicol, then substage mirror or adjustable glass, and illuminator or illumination. Now let's discuss about each part in detail. So first is your microscopic tube. It is a straight metal. Here is the microscopic tube. It is a microscopic tube. It is a straight metal tube which separates the objective from the eyepiece or ocular. So this is your ocular or eyepiece, and this is your objective, and this is your microscopic tube. The microscopic tube separates from ocular or eyepiece from objective. Then the ocular or eyepiece. So what is eyepiece? What is the function of eyepiece? It magnifies the specimen image. It is where you look through the view the object placed on the stage. This is your eyepiece or ocular. The removable lens assembly that fits into the top of the microscopic tube is called ocular. The ocular is, or eyepiece is, removable. The assembly consists of two plano-convex lens, that is small upper lens is called eye lens, and the large lower lens is called field lens. Here you can see there is two lens in the eyepiece. Two lens is there. One is your upper lens, eye lens, and lower lens or field lens. There are two types of lens are present, that is Huygenian eyepiece and Ramsden eyepiece. The Huygenian eyepiece is called negative eyepiece because its focal plane parallel lies between eye lens and field lens. Because its focal lens lies between eye lens and field lens. Then the Ramsden eyepiece is called positive eyepiece because its focal plane lies below its field lens. Okay. Then Bertrand lens. In combination with the ocular, the Bertrand lens form a lower power microscope focus on the upper surface of the objective lens, and it is used to observe interference figure. Bertrand lens, here is the Bertrand lens. It is used for the study of interference figure, and it is present above the objective, and it is used as a lower microscope focus. Okay. Then the analyzer or opernical. Analyzer, here is the analyzer. The polarizing device that can be inserted in between the Bertrand lens and objective lens is between analyzer. The analyzer is present between the objective and Bertrand lens. The analyzer is fixed to pass the light waves which vibrate in north-south plane, and it is used in combination with the polarizer or opernical. Since polarizer passes only east-west direction and analyzer passes only north-south waves, due to the presence of both nickel or crossed nickel, it should produce black field of view. Then comes to the accessory plate or accessory opening. Accessory opening is present directly below the analyzer, through which quartz wedge and gypsum plate and other plates may be inserted into light path. Then comes to the objective lens. Objective lens are used for mineralogical work. The objective lens required, the first is your lower power, that is 2x, or medium power, that is 10x, or high power, that is 50x. The objective lens is used, is the critical component of the microscope, which is used for two basic functions of microscope, that is magnification and resolution. Objective lenses are used for magnification and resolution. Then comes to the arm and base. The arm and base are the frame of the microscope. This is your arm and this is your base. These are the function of support. In vertical tube microscope, the arm is normally connected to the base by an inclination joint that allow both tube and stage to be inclined. So, in inclined tube microscope have no inclination joint, the arm and base are built as a single frame. This is your inclination joint and it is a single frame of joint. Then comes to the microscopic stage or rotating stage. This is your microscopic stage or rotating stage in which we can set the mineral slides for the study. The rotating stage is marked in terms of degree and turns against a vernier scale that can be need in terms of degree or in minutes. This is the value of degree. This thin section of a mineral is examined in this stage. The axis of rotation of this stage coincides with the microscopic axis. This axis of rotation is coincides with the microscopic axis. And in microscopic stage or rotating stage, there is vernier scale, scale of rotation. This vernier scale is coincides with the help of vernier scale, we can determine the extinction angle. Next comes to the substage apparatus. Substage is present beneath the rotating stage. The apparatus present beneath the rotating stage is also is known as substage apparatus. The assembly consists of polarizer, iris diaphragm and one or two filter holders, and these can normally be raised and lower as a unit. The first substage apparatus is your condenser. The condenser is located below the stage, is located just below the stage. The condenser consisting of two simple lenses. Its function is to supply a core of light that enough to fill the front lens of the objective and completely giving the maximum illumination. They are used with high power objective and produce a converging light ray when required. Then comes to the iris diaphragm. So what is iris diaphragm? This is a disc shaped device. This is iris diaphragm. This is a disc shaped device located beneath stage, controls amount of light passing through specimen. Iris diaphragm is located under the condenser. It regulates the intensity of light. It regulates intensity of light or control the amount of light passing through it. Its major function is to increase the natural contrast through the refraction and not nearly the image. Naturally, gray filter is used for controlling the light intensity. Then comes to the lower nickel or polarizer. Polarizer is present below the or bottom part of the substrate. Polarizer passes waves in the direction east-west direction. When polarizer and analyzer both are inserted, they are mutually perpendicular to each other and forming a crossed nickel. It produces a black field of view. The polarizer and analyzer both are right angle to each other. This is your polarized light microscope configuration. When light passes through the polarizer, plain polarized light form, then birefringent specimen. Extraordinary ray emerged out and ordinary ray reflected through the extraordinary ray emerged out through the analyzer and produce recombined light rays after interference, and we can study the minerals in detail. Then comes to the substase mirror. Substase mirror is present below the polarizer, and it is also known as mirror or light source. Microscope do not produce its own light of source. The substase mirror reflect the light from illuminator to the optic axis, optic device system. One side of the mirror is flat and other side is concave. Then illuminator. What is illuminator? Illuminator is the light source for a microscope. A compound light microscope uses a low voltage bulbs as an illuminator. Stage is the flat platform where the slide is placed. Here slide is placed, and illuminator is the light source of microscope. This is your illuminator, or it is used to reflect the external light source to the substase mirror. And in this illuminator, light source reflect and through substase mirror or mirror. So this is all about the parts and function of the petrological or polarizing microscope. Thank you.